Over the last year, a lot of things have shut down in our world, but the Church of Jesus Christ doesn't ever shut down. We haven't stopped doing our ministry, and we haven't stopped doing outreach. We have kept reaching out with the love and the grace, the compassion and the message of Jesus. I want to give you a little update. I mean, super little compared to all there is to tell you. But here's some highlights, all right? Here's the first highlight, our food pantry. The last quarter of the year, we got all our numbers in. So for October, November, December, our food pantry was here. And there was times where we would literally have cars out here through the parking lot, down and out onto Garden Road. And so in the last 3 months, we served 2,611 households. All right, 2,611 households. Listen to this. 4,190 children were served by Shoreline Church. And altogether, 10,156 people. Someone say amen. That's your faithfulness, your giving, your tithes, your offerings, and your time serving. All right? This was interesting. Out of the 2,611, and you say, well, how do you know? We count every single person who comes. We talk with them. We take notes. We pray for them. And so for 2,611, cars came through representing households, sometimes one person, sometimes five or six people in the car. Our numbers are each person that's there coming to our food pantry. Out of the 2,611 households who came, we asked 2,611 of them, can we pray for you? And 1,926 families, over 70% of the people said, yes, you can pray for us. And we prayed for and ministered to people in the name of Jesus and offered Bibles in English and Spanish to people who wanted them. That's what your church is doing. If anybody tells you, oh, the church shut down during COVID, you can just say, no, it hasn't. We are serving Jesus. So then how do you do all that? It takes 52 volunteers a week with doing an average of 3-hour shifts to do that. That's you, Shoreline Church. Many of you are hearing saying, no, I come, I'm on the prayer team, I'm on the food team, you're part of that. But it takes 52 people per week doing shifts of 3-hour shifts. We partner with Trader Joe's, Grocery Outlet, Safeway, Ocean Mist Farms, USDA Farms to Families, and others to get that done. You say, well, some of those aren't even Christian groups. That's right. We're the church, but we're working with people who are willing to help those in need, but they give the food to us, and we give it out in the name of Jesus. Praise God for that. We also have been donating to the Bridge Restoration Ministry, Community Homeless Solutions Women's Shelter, Hidden Hills Ranch, and the Monterey Zoo. We've been helping all of them, so if you love animals, we're helping there too, all right? Some of you say, let's help the animals first, but we're going to help everybody, right? We've been feeding homeless people during this time. And a group of 27 volunteers, many part of Shoreline, but some of them in the neighborhoods of Shoreliners, and some of them not even people who go to church at this time, made over 1,500 sandwiches to hand out to people who are in need, who live on the streets. Our clothes closet has continued, and we've served 413 people this last quarter. And this is exciting. We have a ministry called Dress a Girl. In other parts, this is a global pandemic, and there are young girls all around the world who have not been given a gift, and many of them have never had a brand new dress before, and we've provided beautiful brand new dresses. If you're online, you're going to see a picture in just a minute of some of those little girls. But in this quarter, we gave 100 dresses through Operation Christmas Child, 300 we sent to Malawi, and 311 to Zambia, and there are 711 beautiful little girls who are wearing new dresses made by people at Shoreline all over the world. That's what your church is doing. Amen? Our women's shelter, we're not allowed to go to the women's shelter, so we quit, right? No. Our team continues to give laundry soap, bulk toilet paper, garbage bags, and fuzzy blankets, along with handwritten cards, Bible verses, and words of encouragement by phone. We continue that ministry, even though they've shut down in some ways. We've done all we can to minister. We started a new ministry called Kids Club for all these little kids who are stuck at home doing all their learning. We've had a place outdoors, social distancing, where kids could come here and have some time to study and learn and also have some fun and learn about Jesus. Care centers have been closed, but we keep sending cards, personal notes, and volunteers making phone calls to people in care centers. Even though that ministry is not happening like it used to, we're still ministering to those people who can't have anybody come in and see them. Operation Christmas Child, we worked with a whole team of other churches on this, and all together, we collected boxes to give to kids all over the world that had kind of care materials, but also sharing the gospel, with 1,248 boxes going out. I'm not done yet. Hang on. But wait, there's more. Angel Tree, we did the most angels we've ever done. They did 119 children of prisoners who got gifts from people at Shoreline. We cared for all those 119 kids. Now, you're probably thinking, you know, Kevin, you should just have a really good, wonderful, detailed report with all this information. We do. I'm scratching the surface. On the website, if you're at home, on the website. When you go home today, go on the Shoreline website, and at the very top on the main page, it says it's the new 2020 fourth quarter outreach report. Click on that and read the details. And if nothing else, look at the pictures. It's amazing. Here's what I'm trying to say, Shoreline Church. If you ever wondered, does my giving make a difference? Not just what happens on our campus, you make a difference, but we're touching the world and our community. And we're not going to stop because Jesus doesn't stop. Amen? So that's part of my update. I want to give you another little update. Some of you have been asking me, 1040 window, we talked about as a church getting involved in that place in the world that's the most unchurched part of the world. Has that stopped? Well, right now we can't go to that part of the world with travel, but we have people ready with World Mission to partner and go to that part of the world as soon as it opens up, as soon as it's safe. We're going to send somebody there or a team there to find the right place for us to partner. And when they go, they want to bring 250 solar-powered audio Bibles. So we'll be letting you know about that and how you can give towards making sure we have those solar-powered audio Bibles in that language. So when we send somebody there, we're taking with us the Word of God in a way that non-readers in that language can actually hear the Scriptures. We also are researching relief organizations to partner with, and we're very close to having a partnership so that when something happens in our area, in our nation, or in the world, we're ready to send highly trained, focused, gifted people, not just people that want to kind of help out, because in those kind of situations, you need highly trained people. But we're going to train a team of people, both with skills and the gospel, to be part of that. So we haven't backed off there either. And so it kind of goes on and on. So with all that in mind, I've had people saying to me, what happened with First Gift? How did we do this year? And this blew me away. In the midst of a global pandemic, when many of you are struggling financially and many of you are already giving to keep the ministry of Shoreline going forward, in special gifts to launch us into this year, to get kind of, it doesn't do all of our outreach, but it gives us kind of a platform to start with, you all as a congregation gave $197,670. Someone say praise God. Yeah. And so, here's the picture I have in mind. I picture us out there serving, but there's certain things we can't do right now. We can't go to the 1040 window. We can't go into retirement centers. We can't do a lot of these things. I look at Shoreline like little kids at the gate at Disneyland right before it opens. I grew up in Orange County near Disneyland, and I remember being there. When they opened, you'd run in and go to your favorite ride. Be the first one there. I look at Shoreline like waiting at the gates. Open the doors, because we want to go care. We want to keep serving more and more in the name of Jesus. I say this in the best possible way. I am deeply proud of this congregation and your faithfulness and your generosity in a difficult time.